With more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy. Since the dawn of time, human beings have owed everything to the almighty sun that shares its light with all life on Earth. But now, a group of 35 nations, representing more than half of the world's population, is closer than ever to unlocking the secrets of the star's source of energy, hydrogen fusion, which could deliver a clean, safe, and virtually unlimited power supply to humankind for millennia to come. But the way of the sun is fraught with shadow. To succeed, ITER and its seven primary members, China, the European Union, India, Japan, South Korea, Russia, and the United States, must overcome some of the greatest scientific challenges ever conceived and execute one of the grandest political collaborations ever dreamed. Through the shadows of all doubt, we're building a sun on Earth. So after decades of design and preparation, 2020 marks the long-awaited launch of ITER Assembly.
It's no secret that the world needs energy. We also know that the impact of the last 150 years or so of using fossil fuels has been increasingly devastating. And there's a big contest as to whether we can slow down in our consumption or we can find something to replace it with a cleaner alternative. Fusion has some unique characteristics that make it pretty much the absolute perfect energy source. Unlike fission, there is no possibility of a meltdown. If the reaction stops, everything just stops and that's it. It's really hard to do though. With fusion, we're reproducing the energy that's in the core of the sun and all the stars. We do it by creating a metal cage, and within that metal cage, an invisible magnetic cage that will confine what we call a fusion plasma. The idea of magnetic confinement we've been doing for roughly 60 years, building bigger and bigger tokamaks, and finally we've gotten to this. So the ITER project, 35 countries working together for the first time to build an industrial scale machine.
What I think it very much resembles a theater. Downstairs is the central stage, and then we have all these port openings here, port cells. They remind me of theater boxes where the empress and the emperor sort of waved at their people. I think we will not be able to stand here and to wave at ITER. This is certainly going to be a big theater for mankind. We have 150 million degrees inside the core of the plasma. We have 12 Tesla magnetic forces. We have currents in the system of 15 mega amps. So whatever number, figure you look at within ITER, it's big.
Without our members, we can't progress. We need them to believe and be committed throughout this really long project. It's lasting many, many years. So how do you stay committed to something? You have to stay well informed. You have to see what the progress is. So we go out, we do presentations, we meet people from the research community, from industry, policymakers. Everyone has an open invitation to come here and get a worksite tour and learn more about the project. We welcome this because it will help us reach new audiences.
You know, back in Japan, maybe people don't know about ITER, but they're interested, definitely. I have many friends here, many colleagues, and they're doing like great job. They're hardworking every day, morning to evening. But I think, you know, we communications team have the responsibility to spread their effort using social media, outreach.
As energy needs continue to build, we want the next generation to understand how fusion energy can be important. So we bring thousands of kids here every year to actually tour the site. We also try to bring in a lot of journalists. You're seeing a lot more press about ITER these days. There are literally hundreds of factories and laboratories, thousands and thousands of people around the world on multiple continents contributing their ideas to this project to try to change the future of human society.
You know, I'm just an intern student, but like somehow I'm trying to contribute to this like biggest project in the world. This could change the human history. It's great to do this job.
Everybody knows why we are trying to achieve fusion energy, but to sit in the cafeteria or in the canteen and to see all these different nationalities coming together to deliver a new source of energy that can really help us find a solution to prevent our own extinction.
Though fusion scientists all around the world are well aware of the ITER project, to many, ITER may yet remain a mystery. So to help the global public understand what's happening here, the ITER communication team coordinates free visits every day with journalists, researchers, policymakers, and curious citizens of all nations. Whether you want a tour of the worksite, to interview scientists, or study the international collaborative atmosphere of the ITER endeavor, all are welcome to reach out and schedule a visit.
So this is a unique opportunity for visitors to get a tailored, deep tour of the construction site. And they also get the chance to meet with people who explain their daily work at ITER and who give them latest updates on the construction site. Basically, anybody can come. You simply need a booking on our online tool.
We give them the chance, the opportunity to take the bus and to have a worksite tour, and also to go in the visitor center, and we can show them how a plasma is made and what are the main parts of a tokamak.
And I think to bring people and get them witness with their own eyes what's happening here on site is one of the best ways to promote the project and to bring sparkles in the eyes of the visitors.
Opala. Those with glasses.
Pretty special.
Don't forget your water.
So I used to work for a high energy accelerator research infrastructures, and I know how they look like, and I am so amazed to see a new equipment used here.
I'm really interested in what India is doing with particle physics. We also have a neutrino observatory underground coming up in India, and we're also involved in Fermilab in the US, which I got a chance to visit a few months ago. So I'm just taking things off my list, and it's amazing to see what we're doing with, you know, not a lot of resources.
The key feature of this building is the heavy crane. So the tokamak machine is a big machine of 23,000 tons, so it's three times the weight of the Eiffel Tower.
I personally am very fond of these huge marvels of physics, particularly engineering and physics. From my background in engineering, I can understand what are the limitations in terms of time and resources and money which companies and organizations face when they're building such a project. But I believe that they're doing well, and I think we can expect good results in due time. I still am a student. I'm dealing with my dissertation and other stuff. But what I really loved about this experience is that it was immersive. Like we were in there, and we were walking through those phases of manufacturing and production, and those engineers were explaining things, and I feel happy that I can understand some of those terms because of what I studied earlier, so that gets me even more excited. I have tried not just to capture the location and how it looks, I've tried to capture some people while they're working. I like to see people, the emotion that they have, and they do look invested into this thing.
So I'm a PhD student. I come from the Netherlands. I study at Leiden University, and I came here to conduct interviews with people working at ITER. I look into the organizational structure of ITER, and I asked the communication department if I could come to visit and to conduct these interviews, and I'm very grateful that they were able to accommodate this wish, and I had a great time here. And apparently those people would like to make the time for me, and they also said that they were very interested themselves in hearing more about this research. Everyone was very open and was very happy to receive me and to share their stories about their life and work at ITER. And reading first about it and then seeing it in real life, that has been amazing.
I can see from my window that the project is really progressing, and I'm very happy to see that we have a lot of visitors and to contribute in a very small way to make this project advancing.
ITER is not just a dream, it's becoming a reality here in the south of France, and every day it's like a blessing. I'm really happy to be part of this fantastic adventure.
Everyone is very human, very warm, and people like us to talk about their work and what they're doing here. So it's really amazing to share a bit in this enthusiasm and passion. As an outsider, but now today and yesterday also a bit as an insider to see ITER from the inside.
Konnichiwa!
Bonjour!
Bonjour. Shall we do it again? Yeah.
Okay.
Konnichiwa!
Bonjour et bienvenue! Welcome back to ITER Now! This is the end of the video. Thank you for making it this far. You asked some very tough questions this week.
Oh yeah, you did.
So we're happy to get into them.
So Leif, thank you for the question. Ask us what waste produce from fusion reactor process.
Waste, right. Well, the fusion reaction itself only produces a small amount of inert helium and a really hot neutron, which we use to create energy as byproduct. So that's very negligible. Mm-hmm. However, the machine itself, ITER, has made up a bunch of metals on the inside of the machine that will be activated by the stuff in the plasma. Mm-hmm. And that is going to be sort of a hazard for about 100 years only. So unlike fission, where you take a big nucleus of uranium or something, you break it apart and it creates this radioactive waste which lives for hundreds of like thousands of years. This will produce a small amount of waste that can be stored right here on site.
Yeah.
And in about 100 years, it's totally harmless to the environment, to everything.
So we can say fusion energy is clean energy, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Safe. Mm-hmm. And very little waste.
Yeah.
But check out our website for a more scientific answer than that still. Too. Someone named Hyperion1010 says, what happens after Brexit? Oh. Will Britain's contribution to ITER remain intact?
Yes, of course. So basically nothing changes in 11 months, the transition period. Some contracts may need to be negotiated. However, the country, the UK, said they want to remain and stay involved in the project and contribute to this project. So.
Right, and as far as like employees who have contracts working here, their contracts will be honored and nothing will really change as far as any of that's concerned.
So the question from the Art of on YouTube, thank you. I love what you guys are doing.
Nice.
Yeah, ITER is absolutely fantastic. But isn't the advancement of
Stellarators.
Can I do that again?
Sure, okay.
Stellarators. Isn't the advancement of Stellarators rendering this obsolete?
Ah, well, definitely not, you know. So Stellarators, as opposed to tokamaks, these are two different types of machines that are doing fusion. The biggest Stellarator that exists right now is the W7X in Germany. And it's definitely, we're not in competition with any of these other types of fusion. And tokamaks are more researched, they're more tested, it's a safer bet so far, but that doesn't mean we don't want Stellarators being tested. Stellarators and tokamaks definitely have fans in the scientific community, both are supported. You know, the main difference, like our tokamak has like a smooth inner surface where the plasma pieces basically have to do these little spins all the way around, and the Stellarator, the magnets themselves are spun in a really twisted, interesting way. It looks like a snake of like spaghetti or something.
Spaghetti.
And so that the plasma basically can go in more of a straight line because the magnets themselves are twisted. Mm-hmm. That's the difference. But no, you know, like we want all fusion things to be moved on. Like if we succeed first, it doesn't mean that like, all the Stellarators will turn off and stop doing research. Like the people who lead these Stellarators and tokamaks, we all share information freely, completely openly. So we're informing each other's processes and we're all trying to reach the same goal.
Yeah, of fusion energy.
Create fusion.
Yeah.
So thank you. Thank you for your questions very much. I hope we keep doing this. Keep sending good questions.
Yeah.
Keep suggesting fun photos we can put on the green screen here. Honestly, we're still working out the green screen. Look, we're pretty green yet
in
the background. I'm working on the chroma keying. Someone else commented on that. Thank you for the tip. We're still figuring it out, but yes.
Okay.
Thank you for listening. Merci beaucoup.
Sayonara.
Okay, see you next time on ITER Now.
Bye. Stellarators.
Stellarators. Yeah, Stellarators.
Stellarators.
Perfect.
Stellarator.
We hope you have enjoyed this video, and for more videos go to freakphysics.com.